In this video, we explain how to correctly install the PIKO IQ solar inverter from KOSTAL. Please note the information relating to installation and proper use of the device. The PIKO IQ is supplied with all the accessories. The packaging shows the product designation, as well as the following information: serial number, article number, hardware and software versions. To open, place the packaging on the floor as shown. Do not use sharp tools and do not pierce too far into the box. Lift the PIKO IQ out of the packaging and place it safely on the ground. Check that the device is in perfect condition and that all the contents are present. In addition to the PIKO IQ, the scope of delivery includes the following accessories: a quick start guide, installation material comprising of 3 screws and 3 anchors, a wall mounting, 2 pairs of SunClix plugs, 4 plug seals for routing communication cables. During installation, the PIKO IQ can be positioned vertically. On the underside of the PIKO IQ, you will find the ventilation system, as well as the device's connection area. 2 DC connections are provided to connect the PV generators. To make this connection, use the safe-to-touch SunClix plugs provided. Next to the DC connections, you will find 4 cable glands fitted with plug seals. These are used to connect the corresponding cables to the device. The inverter is mounted on the wall using a mounting rail and 3 6x45 screws and S8 screw anchors. Never mount the PIKO IQ on a drywall or timber base. Attach the wall mount to secure a mounting face. Fit the PIKO IQ in the mounting rail and also fix the device with a screw at the intended point. Ensure that the DC switch is set to the off position. Release the screws of the bottom housing cover and take this off. Then unscrew the terminal compartment cover. The device provides various interfaces for establishing a connection to other inverters, sensors, energy meters, or a link to the internet. Release the union nuts of the cable glands and remove the plug seal on the underside of the PIKO IQ. Now route the AC power cable through the cable aperture in the cable gland. Reseal the mains cable by again tightly screwing down the sealing ring and union nut with the cable on the inverter. Note the specified torque. Connect the wires of the mains cable to the AC terminal in accordance with the labeling. Insert the individual wires into the large, round aperture on the AC terminal. When using cables with fine wires, core and sleeve should be used. Ensure that there is a contact surface of 18 millimeters. The AC cable is now connected. The device uses SunClix connectors. To quickly and easily connect the PV strings to the inverter, please use the pairs of SunClix plugs provided. The smart communication board is the inverter's communication hub. It is located above the AC terminal and has several connections. The Ethernet interface allows you to integrate the inverter into your local network. The inverter can use the LAN connection to transmit its data to the portal via the network. The connection also ensures access to the web server. Guide the LAN cable through the cable gland and then through the cable aperture on the inverter. If necessary, replace the plug seal in the cable gland with the appropriate plug seal from the scope of supply. Note the specified torque for the cable gland. connect the network cable with the RJ45 socket on the smart communication board. Then connect the Ethernet cable on the computer, router, or switch. If you want to monitor your home consumption, you will have to install the KOSTAL Smart Energy Meter. To do this, please watch the KOSTAL video for the Smart Energy Meter. Tighten all cable glands and check that they are well sealed. Screw the cover flap for the terminal compartment and housing cover back onto the inverter. Now connect the PV cables with the inverter. Note, if there is more than one inverter in a PV system, ensure that no cross connections occur when the PV generators are connected. Remove the plug seal on the left underside and connect sockets and plugs to DC inputs. Note, ensure correct polarity. The poles of the PV strings must not be earthed. This device is now ready for commissioning. Switch on the AC supply and move the DC circuit switch to the I position. The commissioning wizard now launches in the display. The next video will explain how to enter all the necessary settings. To safely commission the device, please read the operating instructions for the PIKO IQ.